हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज आकांक्ष सुमन हियर। नाउ वी विल डू क्वेश्चंस बेस्ड ऑन द एपिसाइक्लिक गियर ट्रेन। इन द गियर ट्रेन द व्हेन द एक्सिस ऑफ द शाफ्ट ओवर विच द गियर्स आर माउंटेड मूव रिलेटिव टू द फिक्स एक्सिस देन वी कॉल इट एज एपिसाइक्लिक गियर ट्रेन। सो आंसर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन इज एपिसाइक्लिक गियर ट्रेन। Now we need to understand it, what the question is going to say. The axis of the shaft, for example, this is the shaft, okay? The axis of the shaft over which the gears are mounted, okay? This is the mounted gear, okay? The shaft, this is the shaft axis and the gears which is mounted on the shaft and which is more related to the fixed axis. That means there is having the fixed axis. For example, this is another gear and this is having the fixed axis, okay? If the gear is fixed and this is more relative to the axis of the gear A, then we call it as the epicyclic gear train, and this is the arm. So what is the definitions of the epicyclic gear train? Apart from the axis of rotation of the gear, if any axis of the gear is in rotation with respect to some other axis of the gear, is termed as the epicyclic gear train. It may be the simple epicyclic, it may be compound epicyclic, it may be reverted epicyclic, okay, and so on. So what is the basic criteria for the epicyclic gear train? You can see here the axis of the gear is in rotation with some other axis of the gear, then we call it as the epicyclic gear train, okay? So for this question, answer is option D. And what is the compound gear train? When there are more than one gear are mounted on the same shaft, we can call it as the compound gear train, okay? So that is the epicyclic gear train we have see here, okay? So thank you.